Hi everyone, welcome back. I'm Melissa Muir. One more time, I have joined with Halstead Bead for another fun video. This time we are making threader earrings. I'm going to show you very quickly how I do two different pairs. But let's take a look now and see how it's done. For the first pair of earrings, I'm going to take my little drop here and clean it up. I just want to make sure there's no oils or anything like that. So I'm using a green scrubby just to go over the surface lightly. Next up, we're going to flux all of our pieces. So in this case, the marquee drop and the two tube settings, both the 2 millimeter and the 3 millimeter. I'm going to get these positioned into place approximately because I can always move them around a little bit more, but we want to get it fairly close. As the flux dries, things might move around just a little bit. Next, I'm going to bring in my torch and just dry the flux. We want to do this so that the solder doesn't bubble out of place when we get it into position. Then I'm just going to place a small piece of solder inside of each cup, making certain that that solder touches the edges. I don't want to apply too much heat onto the settings, especially those tube setting walls, as the solder will just blow up those. So notice that my heat is directed onto my board rather than onto the piece. The piece will absorb that heat and the solder will flow. So here we can see it's flown on the big one and there it goes on that small piece. Quench and pickle these, and now we are ready to set the stones. I'm going to just pick up one of those small 2 millimeter stones and put it into position. Once it's in position, I'm going to take a tube setting and just gently tap with a hammer. It's going to fold that bezel nicely over my stone. Once that is done for both of the smaller ones, I'm now ready to move on to the larger stones. These are 3 millimeters. Notice that I'm taking the time here to make certain that that stone is level. I want the top of that stone to be flush with the outer edges. One more time, I'm going to bring in my tube setting punch and gently tap as I rock around the stone. Now I'm going to repeat for the next drop. Now it is important that you take the time to make certain the stone is flush and flat. Otherwise, when you go to set this, you can actually pop the stone out and it will damage that bezel to the point where you won't be able to set a stone back in there. As a final step, I'm going to take that same tube setting punch and just rub it around that setting. This is going to make sure everything is laid down nice and evenly, and it's also going to give us a beautiful high polish on that outer edge of the piece. So I repeat that even for the 2 millimeter stones. Now that we have these all done, it is time to assemble our earrings. I'm using some small jump rings here. Open that up by twisting, put on my drop, attach my chain, and then I'm going to use my pliers to close this back up. Sometimes there ends up being a little bit of a gap, so I find that if I wiggle and push the ring closed at the same time, it helps to really close that gap. Now we're going to repeat for the other side. Again, twist it open, put on the drop, and apply the chain. And now we are finished with our first pair of threader earrings. For the second pair, I'm going to be setting a stone in these quick snap settings that you can get through Halstead. I'm going to be setting the prongs with my hammer handpiece, so I need something to hold this into place. And here I've put my settings into a piece of thermoplastic. And this makes it so that it holds it into place nice and neat. I apply pressure barely to my prongs with the hammer handpiece, and that will allow me to push those prongs right over on top of the stone. Now this is a delicate operation. Here on this piece, I happen to have 4 prongs, so you want to work kind of in a crisscross motion. So if I do the lower right, then I want to turn it over and do the upper left. Now that I have these set, it's time to again assemble our earrings. Open my jump ring, attach my drop, and then attach the ear threader. One more time, we're going to close this up and repeat for the second earring. Threader earrings can be kind of fun. So what you're going to do is put in the end and you simply pull this chain all the way through your ear. Now these can be worn so that the drop is long, but the ear threader part is short. Or I can move it around and I can have them be approximately the same length, as well as coming back in and making it so that my drop sits closer to the earlobe. So as you can see, they're actually quite versatile.